we are going to have an encore performance from Dan Hill. He is a Cayuga of the Heron Clan. He tries through his music to give everyone a feeling of the sounds of the natural world and how it supports us. So please welcome Dan Hill again.
I always try to think of what I'm going to say when I get up here, and I can never remember. But that's why I like doing this, because for me it's the sound of the flute that tells me what to say, and I'm reminded of my grandmother's talks and my upbringing on Tuscarora Reservation outside of Niagara Falls. Just a mile north of Niagara Falls is all the tailings from the Manhattan Project. And that's one of our concerns, is the nuclear waste, along with hydrofracking. I work for the Haudenosaunee Environmental Task Force, and we're given the chore from the Grand Council of Chiefs that we're to keep track and make sure everybody knows about hydrofracking. A week after the Japanese earthquake, I was flying to Phoenix. The same time, the radioactivity was reaching the West Coast. And it was on the flight, I'm looking at the clouds up that high, trying to see any change in the atmosphere. Because when Saddam burned the oil fields in the First War, or the Second War, whatever, they lose track. I was flying back and forth between Buffalo and Los Angeles, and you could see a brown layer of smog, oil, way up high. And I've always followed the waters and the storms, because they create waves. And when I lived in California, that's what I liked, was the waves and the ocean. And it taught me that we're all connected. We're all downwind from somebody. We're all upwind, upriver from somebody. Hydrofracking is going to affect everybody. It started in Russia, and it's changed some of the lakes and stuff. It's drained the lakes. It's drained the aquifer in Texas. It's done all these things that, by fracturing the shell of the turtle. This is Turtle Island. By fracturing that shell, the water levels have changed and departed from different areas. Wind River Indian Reservation, that one slide he just showed you, takes an hour to drive through Wind River. All that water is gone. You can't drink the water because of hydrofracking. We work with the International Joint Commission for the Great Lakes. They're already concerned for 50 years from now when there's no water anywhere else. 20% of the fresh water is here. Who's going to be fighting over it? Who's going to be dividing it? Because as a human being, as a two-legged human being, you can't let other people suffer. You're not supposed to. That's what my grandmother taught me. You have to watch out for the two-leggeds, the four-leggeds, the birds that fly in the air. You have to watch out for the process of the earth giving us life. The song is called Aquifer because it's in honor of the earth cleaning the waters and bringing up fresh water. It seems like we're overburdening that process.